This video will cover where to locate the IntraVUE host computer and the installation process. Before installing IntraVUE on a computer, you should understand how placement of the host computer may affect the data you collect. The computer you are using to view this video may or may not be a good choice. The IntraVUE host computer or computers should be located in accordance with your device-centric point of view. This diagram is a simplification of the plant portion of a network. Let's consider an enterprise system pulling real-time data from the plant floor. The enterprise is connected to the plant through a router. While IntraVUE is capable of scanning through routers, the best practice is to scan local, view remote. IntraVUE should be placed on a switch which is located close to the router, inside the plant network. The statistics collected by IntraVUE will then match the enterprise view of the network. Another example is an operator station, which is being fed data by many devices. The main concern in this application is the flow of data to the operator station. Thus, IntraVUE should be installed on a switch close to the operator station, so monitoring and data provide diagnostics at the source. Some applications may justify several IntraVUEs installed in the network, or even at every operator station. Placement of the IntraVUE host is flexible and should match the way you view the Ethernet-connected devices at your facility. Now that we have covered placing the IntraVUE host, let's continue with the actual installation. IntraVUE is distributed in two main forms: the distribution CD, which contains many videos as well as the installation program, and a web-based link to download just the installation program. You normally start the installer from the CD by clicking on the Install IntraVUE button. This will run the installer. But if you are on a Windows Server-based platform, you must install IntraVUE using the Add Programs function contained in the Windows Control Panel. The actual executable program is located in the installation folder of the CD and is called Install IntraVUE with some additional version numbers .exe. When you click Next on the Welcome screen, the Quick Start Guide is launched and the dongle is checked. I'm going to close the Quick Start Guide. You can read it at your convenience. If the USB dongle has never been installed on the host computer, be sure it is removed at this point. You should see a screen like this asking that the dongle not be inserted yet. If you're upgrading, you won't see this screen and you may leave the dongle in. Clicking on Next, there will be a delay of 20 or 30 seconds while the dongle files are installed on your computer. Now you are asked to put the dongle in the USB port. In most, but not all cases, you will see the Windows Found New Hardware wizard appear. Hit Next after the Hardware wizard. In this case, we didn't see it. You should now see the information page. At the top of the screen is information about any previous IntraVUE installations, and at the bottom is information about the dongle that you have, showing you the product key and the dongle key code. Hit Next. There's only a choice to uninstall the current version if you have one and reinstall it, or to install a licensed version. Enter your email contact and company. And hit Next. take a quick look at the license, agree, and select the location you would like to install IntraVUE. Select Next. Start the installation process. If IntraVUE was already installed, a backup is made of the current database. Any previous versions of IntraVUE and its components will be uninstalled. And new components will be installed. When installation is complete, two web pages will display. One is the Help Welcome page with links to new installation and the table of contents. The new installation help page contains information to get you started. The other web page is the IntraVUE browser. All your interaction with IntraVUE is through a browser. In addition to Internet Explorer, Mozilla Thunderbird works very well. This concludes the placement and installation video. The next logical video to watch is adding scan ranges.